Hey guys, we are working on chapter 7 now, and we're working on something called polynomials. And it's really introductory because we're just starting the chapter, assuming you use the same book as we do in class. But let's talk about what a polynomial is, and hopefully you watched the prior video where you went into how to name the polynomials. And really, mostly for this video, this is the essential question, is how can I add and subtract polynomials? We want to focus on just adding and subtracting them together. So I'm going to give you an example of what I am talking about. So we'll write example one. So I'm talking about adding expressions together. I'm not solving for x because there's no equal sign involved. I can't solve for x even if I wanted to. I'm just simplifying essentially. So here is two expressions that I am going to add together. The first one is parentheses, x to the third minus 2x squared plus 5, plus another parentheses, 4x to the third plus x minus 7. Now, my directions on this are purely to simplify because like I said just a second ago, you can't solve even if you wanted to. Like, if you wanted to solve for x, it's going to be impossible because you have no equal sign. It's not an equation. So over here on the main idea side of my notes, I'm going to put an equal sign. This is what you need when you have an equation. We do not have an equation. So what I'm going to do is cross this out and say, not an equation. We can't solve for x even if we really, really wanted to. We don't have enough information. The only thing I can do is clean this mess up. It's pretty messy right now. It's these two big parentheses, adding all this stuff together. I would like to clean that up if possible. So let's go through how we clean this up. What's the strategy? Well, the strategy is we put like terms together. So I see an x to the third, and I see another x to the third. We're going to add those together because it's an addition problem. So I'm going to take x to the third, this first one, cross it out, and I'm going to add it to 4x to the third. And I'll cross it out. And this process of crossing them out helps me stay organized for when these get longer and bigger, because they will, they're gonna get longer and bigger and messier. Then I see a minus 2x squared, but I don't see any x squareds over here to match with it. So I think the minus 2x squared is kinda on its own, okay? I see a plus 5, I see a minus 7, those will go together, but I also see this plus x that has nothing to go with it, so I'll put the plus x right here. And then I'm going to put the plus 5, cross it out, and the minus 7, cross it out. And now I've used all of my parts. So now we just combine these like terms. So we put the x cubed plus the 4x cubed together. Now we have 5x cubed. I would put these together, but I can't. They're not the same. So the minus 2x squared is just there. That just kind of comes down. The plus x, again, nothing to go with it. So that just comes down. And then the 5 minus 7 I can do. 5 take away 7 would have to be a minus 2, a negative 2. And then that is it. We have now simplified our expression. So this thing right here is going to be my final solution to this question. It is to the highest power of 3, so it's cubic. It's a third degree if I wanted to name it. So I'm going to name this thing third degree, which makes it cubic. We also know it's a third degree cubic polynomial because it's got one, two, three, four pieces, four terms to it. So it's big, it's a polynomial. I can't call it a trinomial because it would have to have three terms. I can't call it a binomial because it would have to have two terms. So this is just a polynomial. And then I'm done. I've named it, I've simplified it. There's not much more I can do, to be honest. Some of you on the homework recently have been doing these. Great, you've been getting the right answers, but you're not showing any of this middle step. So all I am seeing is the question and the answer with no middle step. And the problem with that is that's going to make other teachers probably question you and wonder if you're just copying down the answer from someone or if you really know what you're doing. So this little in-between process right here, where I'm crossing out the parts and showing the combinations of like terms, it's pretty important. That's showing your work. So if you're one of those people who's like, "Oh, I'm just doing it all in my head." Well, doing it all in your head means nobody else knows what you're doing. So please get it out of your head, get it on paper. Don't be too lazy about it. Get this middle step in there because that's, like I said, that's showing your process. Now, these are pretty good problems because we can totally practice good multiple choice strategies with them. So I'm going to take one of these problems and make it a multiple choice problem. So we'll call this example two. So make a little space to write example. I'll put it over here, example two. And kind of cheated and pre-printed this out ahead of time. So you're going to have to probably pause the video. I'm going to zoom in so you can see it a little better. Just hit pause on your device and take a moment to copy this question down so you have it. But it's just a simplified problem. We're going to simplify this thing. 2p to the third minus 5p plus 2p squared minus parenthesis 2p plus 6p squared plus 3p to the third. And then we have these choices, A, B, C, and D. So, like I said, right now, pause the device, take a minute. It's going to take a little while to copy all of this down. I want you to write the whole thing down in your notes, including the A, B, C, D. Go ahead and do that. All right. So, you're hopefully unpausing your device at this point. You have it all written down, and we're going to go through the process. Now, many of the tests that you guys are taking these days are often online. I mean, that's just kind of the world we live in. So for jobs and different things like that, we often have to go to testing centers and do certification tests, and everything's on a computer screen. Even right now, you're watching notes probably on a screen, right? So we have to practice how to look at a screen and take the work off the screen and get it onto paper to kind of practice the strategies. So if this was me, and I was looking at a computer screen and I saw this problem, I would, of course, copy the problem down. That would be my first strategy. So I would go to my paper where I had space and I would copy 2p to the third minus 5p plus 2p squared minus parentheses 2p plus 6p squared plus 3p to the third. Oh, sorry, and you can't see, so I'm gonna zoom out. So, what do you think the most common mistake people make on computerized tests is? They don't copy the problem correctly. Honestly, you look at the screen, you start writing it down on your paper, and you mix up one of the, I mean, look how easy it would be to make this third accidentally a squared or something like that. It is so simple to make like copying errors. So I always, if it's a test or something that I care about, I always go back and just double check it. 2p to the third, yep, minus 5p, yep. Plus 2p squared, yep. Subtraction sign in the middle, yep. 2p plus 6p squared plus 3p to the third. Okay, I'm good. Like, double check your work. If it's something you care about doing well on, if it's a test or a certification or a state test, then slow down and take that time to double check because these answers are purposely going to have mistakes in them. They're going to pick ABCDs that have easy errors in them that you could make. So if you miscopy, you might see your answer in one of those choices, and you're totally falling for the trick right there. So that's just one piece of advice I would give you. Now let's go through how we do this problem. Since it's a subtraction problem, we're going to need to distribute our subtraction problem, or our subtraction sign, I mean, into this problem. So we're actually subtracting 2p, subtracting 6p squared, and subtracting 3p to the third. And what I'm going to do is go through my process of combining my like terms. So I'm going to start with 2p to the third. This way we're getting rid of the parentheses. And over here I see it could combine with this thing, 3p to the third. And it's a plus 3p, but remember the subtraction sign, so it's actually a minus 3p to the third. And that takes care of this one. I'm going to take, let's see, let's go highest powers. Highest powers would be next would be squareds. So I'm going to take 2p squared, which is a plus 2p squared, cross it out, and I'm going to be combining it over here with this plus 6p squared. But it's not a plus, it's a minus because of that distribute. So it's a minus 6p squared. Those will combine. Now the only thing left is this minus 5p, so we'll get that minus 5p. There we go. And this 2p, which is also a minus 2p, minus 2p. Boom. Okay, now we're looking good. So let's start using some strategies here of combining like terms. We're going to take 2p to the third, and we're going to subtract 3p to the third. 2 take away 3 is a negative 1, a negative 1p to the third, which we know is really just negative p to the third. So already, I'm going to use some of my strategies here on my multiple choice. Which answers can I immediately eliminate as options? We'll look at a. A is a minus 6p to the third. A looks like we, here it's really small, I apologize for that, but a looks like we could eliminate it. Minus 6p to the third, we got a minus p to the third. That's not an option. B is, I'm agreeing with that one. C looks like an option for sure. D, not an option, minus 6p to the third. So already, I have now narrowed it down to two possible answers. It's either B or C. So we've got this thing narrowed down a little bit. And that's a good strategy right there, because now if I had to guess, I've at least got a 50-50 shot. But I don't think I need to guess, because I think I know how to do the rest of this math. So let's combine the next piece. 2p squared minus 6p squared. 2 take away 6 would have to be a negative 4p squared. And if you look at our answer choices, they both have a negative 4p squared. So I can't eliminate B or C yet. I'm still got to keep going. So now I have negative 5 take away 2p. Negative 5 take away another 2 is a negative 7p. And here is our expression. Highest power is a third degree, so we're looking at a third degree problem. It's cubic again, so third degree cubic. And it's got 1, 2, 3 terms, so we name that a trinomial. So it's third degree cubic trinomial is its name. But that's really not part of the multiple choice. I'm just adding that on for extra so I can be a little more advanced with this problem. What's our multiple choice answer up here? Let's see. Ooh, it looks like it's C. Look, minus 7p, that matches up with what we got. So B is not the correct answer. I can cross that out. And C is my final answer. Boom. So process of elimination is a strategy I like to use on almost all of my multiple choice problems, to be totally honest. It really helps me narrow it down. And at least if I end up in a situation where I'm a little bit guessing, I feel like I have a better shot at my guess. So always a good strategy. So for your last problem in this video, it's going to be a U-try problem, and it's going to be multiple choice. I'd like you to try a multiple choice problem on your own, practicing some of those strategies I was just mentioning. So I'm going to write up here, U-try. And you can see the problem here. I'm going to read it to you once and let you write it down in your notebook. So the problem is we have a parentheses, 4x to the fourth power minus 4 minus 7x plus 2x to the fourth power plus 4 minus 4x. And then here are A, B, C, D options. So right now that you're going to need to pause your device and take a few minutes just to copy the problem. It'll take a little while to get that A, B, C, D copied correctly. And then I want you to try. Give this your best shot. And when you're ready to check your answer, unpause your device. Go ahead and do it. All right, are you unpausing your device? I'm going to guess you are, and I'm going to zoom out a little bit, and I'm going to go through this so you can check your answer. So let's see if we agree on our answer. So first strategy on a computerized test is to copy the problem down on your paper correctly. So I'm going to be very careful to make sure I get all the parts correct. 4x to the fourth minus 4 minus 7x plus sign in the middle, 2x to the fourth plus 4 minus 4x. And then what I'm going to do is start putting pieces together. So I'm going to start with the 4x to the fourth, this first piece, cross it out, and I'm going to be combining it with the plus 2x to the fourth that is over here, plus 2x to the fourth. So that takes care of those. Next thing I have is a number, minus 4, and I have this minus 7x. I think I'm going to do the x's next. So minus 7x, that'd be this part, is going to combine with a minus 4x, this part. And then final piece is a minus 4 and a plus 4 is what it looks like, a minus 4 and a plus 4. So that would be this piece and this piece. And then we'll combine our like terms. So let's combine some things together. Let's see, 4x to the fourth and 2x to the fourth add up to 6x to the fourths. So already on my multiple choice, I'm like, well, A might be the answer. But B's not. 14x to the fourth, that one's out. C could be my answer. And D, that's out. 8x to the fourth, that won't work because I got 6x to the fourth. So we've eliminated a little bit. So that's good. We're down to either A or C. Now I'm going to do the minus 7x and the minus 4x. 7 and 4 combined to 11, it'd be a minus 11x. But if you notice in our problem, we have minus 11x on both a and c, so still not narrowed down. But I'm getting close because I know negative 4 plus 4 just combines to 0. That's going to wipe out. So my answer is just 6x to the 4th minus 11x. It looks like it's answer C again. It looks like this one, another C. So how did you do? Did you get the same thing as me? Letter C? Did you show your work the same way I did? Did any of you try to name it and go that extra step? This is a fourth degree problem, so fourth degree. And if you really want to get fancy, we call fourth degrees quartic problems. You can add that on. I think it's like this, quartic. I barely ever have to use that phrase. And there's two terms, so it's a binomial. Binomial. And that's it. There's our name. So that's going to wrap up our video today, you guys. The big summary takeaway, if you're doing a summary at the bottom of your notes, is the multiple choice strategies of elimination, trying to eliminate our answers. And the second big takeaway is this thing, showing your work, not going through this process in your head, but actually putting it down on paper. Don't let it all be in your head where nobody can see it. So that's the second takeaway. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video.